Welcome back to Switch to Linux. Well, today we want to talk about the latest news from Linux Mint. Once again, Linux Mint is demonstrating that they are willing to listen to their users, and this is one of the compelling reasons I like to use Linux Mint. So welcome back to the show. Well, the first of the month, the director of Linux Mint, who is Clem, he releases monthly news to keep us all up to date as to what's going on, whether there's an upcoming release or not. And in this week's monthly news, or month's monthly news, he releases some basic information. First and foremost, if you are using Linux Mint 19, you ran an update. They did have an update which broke things. They were able to get that fixed. They pulled the updates, I think, within a day of having some issues and gave a link to the forum post for how to fix the information there. Fortunately, since I don't update my computers on a regular basis, I was not impacted by this, but they did actually fix that. The biggest news here out of this is the one that I thought was the absolute greatest thing. So we're going to hit it last. We'll come back to that. We do have a sticky notes that they are playing around with. This is an alpha build. They don't have a dev package or anything else to push out in beta yet. And so I did not bother going in and making the package, but it is available on GitHub. Basically, it's going to allow you to do sticky notes. It's going to put them on your desktop and give you a system tray by which to manage your sticky notes to have little things. I mean, I would do that, but, you know, I just like the real paper ones, actually. It's what I tend to use. And then they're talking about IPTV and 3MU in particular. So if you use 3MU IPTV on your phone, tablet, or smart TV, would you be interested in watching and possibly recording in Linux? This is something that they are looking for information on, see if it's something they would like to do. Of course, we've already did a whole video about the web app manager based on ICE, so we're not going to talk about that much here, but you can download the dev version of that if you would like to try it out. And then we have some hardware video acceleration for the media player, which is celluloid. And what they're going to do here is they are going to be enabling video hardware acceleration by default. So this is going to allow the video to pull in and utilize your video hardware rather than your processor, which should see a drop in processor function, but a smoother playback on video, particularly if you have a good video card. You can enable that if you'd like to by going into your preferences of the current one, but as of Mint 20.1, that will be enabled by default. They also have a new driver manager coming out. Apparently, they are going to be dropping the Ubuntu driver manager, and they are going to be using a driver manager that is going to be switch to package kit is what it is. So this will hopefully get us a little bit more. Maybe what I see them doing is relying a little bit less on Ubuntu at this point, and that might be where we are getting to. And then some extra USB printer support. Now, what we want to spend most of our time on today is this Chromium build. This was probably the stupidest thing that they did when they released 20. I'm not a fan of snaps, but instead of packaging a real version of Chromium like Pop! OS did, they just packaged an empty package and talked about why they did that. Now, they do have a list in their user's manual, which will point you to a variety of ways to install Chromium, but a lot of their users were still bothered that we had that problem to begin with, that we had to go through extra steps to install Chromium. So as of the next release, they will have Chromium packaged into it, and it's going to, right now it is testable as a deb file. You can grab it for Mint 20 or for Linux Mint Debian Edition. As of right now, they do appear to be the same file, but some of the dependencies are going to be pulled in a little bit different. I did double check, and as of this beta version here that they're looking for feedback on, it is the current version available on Linux. It is a little bit behind what is available on Mac or Windows, but it is the current version on Linux. So what I did is I came over here and I installed that already. So you can see in my software manager, Chromium web browser, this is the dev package that I downloaded. You can see this is the one that they have in their repositories for Linux Mint 20. And this is the empty package complaining about the snap packages. I agree with not wanting to use the snap version. I understand why they did this. Although, for sure, this was a controversial view. I always said that they should have packaged their own Chromium rather than do that. But now they are going to be doing just that. Same thing that Pop! OS does. So when we go ahead and install the dev package, you're just going to get your Chromium web browser. It's going to integrate well within your theming. And you can see down here from the about, we are at 85.04.183.21, which I did double check, and that is the current version available on Linux as of now. Let's go ahead and test how the theming works, and we'll just test the theming by pulling up the welcome screen again because they have the very nice first steps toggler. So let's go with an orange dark theme. That should be enough of a change. And if we pull up our Chromium web browser, you can see that it's going to be theming everything the same way there. So that's actually really good. If you remember from the video that we did looking at Chromium installing it with their user's guide versus Chromium installing it as a snap package, you will actually recall that the snap package, while it worked, did not match any system theming at all. The dev package did. So in this case here, we will have a packageable build of Chromium inside of this, which is going to work just fine. Now, of course, the other thing that I did is I did install the web apps on here as well. We have a whole separate video on this, but this is basically the web app tool that we now have. So you can see we can go with Firefox or Chromium. Since I have both of those enabled, we can set what category, and then we just go ahead and give it a website name. Let's just call it Switched to Linux, and then just enter your URL. And then it's going to automatically pull the icon. You can actually click this and set any icon that you would like, but we'll just go ahead and hit cancel on that. Set it where you want it, so internet is good. You can enable or disable the navigation bar, and then you can choose whether this is going Chromium or Firefox. So here on Chromium, you'll see our options are isolated profile or not. On Firefox, they are always isolated. The question is, do you want the navigation bar or not? Let's go with Firefox and do a navigation bar because I've not tested what that one actually looks like on this yet. So there you have it. We have our navigation bar and you have your website loading up there as a web app. And then, of course, that's going to be in your menu under internet. Oh, it should be there. I think you might have to reboot the system to get it up in the menu, but it will appear in the menu the next time it loads Cinnamon. We could go into the terminal and reboot Cinnamon, and that would work as well. So there is what Linux Mint is up to. They are indeed packaging Chromium. So if you are a user of Linux Mint, you want to go ahead and test out the dev package for these, give them any feedback that you might have. So far, just quick, simple testing of it on this build of Linux Mint 20, and it works out excellent. So very pleased to see this. I think that this is that one thing that they should have done differently from the get-go, and now they are doing it. They're listening to their users, and that is why I continue to love and use and recommend and support Linux Mint. So thanks for coming along, and I hope that you enjoy switching to Linux. Thank you for watching this video from Switched to Linux. This channel would not be possible without the backing of the program supporters scrolling on the screen now. You can be a supporter at Patreon at patreon.com/TOMM or at thinklifemedia.com. I also want to thank the open source community who creates such excellent software that makes producing this show possible. Please remember to support your software communities. Thank you, and I hope that you enjoy switching to Linux.